What's up, gamers? It's your boy, Oshpat1412 here. And we got full game Saturday, man. Pretty excited about it. I'm going to try to keep the tradition rolling a little bit. I know I didn't have it last week. But we got this one. We got Draft Champions gameplay. I was going to do an online ranked match. I forgot I had a pretty good squad over here on the Draft Champions. This squad is pretty sick, you know, especially offensively. I got Allen Hurns, 92 overall. I got Matty Ice, Matt Ryan at the quarterback. I got Jordy Nelson at the 3 slot. And I got, what's my man's name? Vincent Jackson. Vincent Jackson, 97 overall at the 1 spot for wide receiver, of course. So, I think I got Antonio Gates at the tight end. So, I got a pretty nice squad, man. I was like, man, let me show them this. You know what I mean? This will probably be... I said a little more entertaining, but still pretty. Oh wow, look at this! Oh wow, right through the scenes. Oh my goodness! Dang, now that Kevin White though was a beast though. I will say that it was two guys back there, so I kind of left it alone. I kind of thought, they would have it, but the angle looked the way it looked like they have it, but then the ball like kind of just did it did like a leap a little bit or something. I don't know. Dang, first play of the drive, though. My goodness. All right, not bad. Anybody can throw through the seams, though. It's just hiding whether you have the seams open or not. That's the part. That's the part right there. It's a lot easier to throw through the seams in this Madden opposed to previous Maddens. But, hey, you know, it is what it is. Is that Devin Hester? No, that's Avery. Okay, my goodness. All right, let's see what we got here. I don't even remember, I haven't played with this playbook in a long time, that's for sure. We're going to see what we can do with it, though. Well, we took a little bit too long to get that off. You got to get that out your hand, Matty Ice. We're going to try some Michael Bush here. I'm not sure how far we're going to go with it, but we're going to try, though. We'll see what we can do with him. I had a pretty good game the other day. Who was it I was playing with? I can't remember who it was, but... Not bad. That wasn't bad right there.
After that last carry, it's third and three.
Ryan takes it from the gun. Wow, wait, hold on to that. Wow. Good pass, good catch. My goodness. Hey, he can see it already? He must have something he had to do. Who can see when they up 7? Must have something he had to do right there. I'm going to try to get another one in. Man, that was crazy. One of these days, I'm going to give you guys a tour of my little space here. It's not much, but it's a little something here. My little, I guess you can call it a man cave, so to speak. So I'm gonna give y'all a tour of that one day. I gotta get it straightened up though. But I got some interesting stuff here, you know, a couple old fantasy football books, top 500 greatest players, NBA players of all time. Let's see what we got in here, you know what I mean? While we're waiting, Gerald Wilkins, 446. If you don't know who Gerald Wilkins is, that's actually Dominique Wilkins' brother. I remember when I was a kid, you know, being him. Sam Bowie got 447. Wow, I'm shocked he made the list a little bit. A little shocked. Dale Curry, Stephen Curry's dad is 450 in this book at this time. I think LeBron James is still in the Miami Heat at this time. And Charles Smith. And he used to play for they got him with the Clippers. Dude. I don't know if y'all even know who Charles Smith is, but he used to play for the Knicks when Patrick Ewing was playing. I believe he was a starting power forward or small forward, but I think it was power forward, if I'm not mistaken. I believe he was starting. Josh Howell, I haven't heard that name in a long time. Emeka Okafor? Wow. 452. Little shocked he made the list. Top 500 greatest players of all time. Wow. Hedo Turkoglu, 454. Kevin Martin, 455. Wow. Jason White Chocolate Williams, 457. David Lee at 458. Kerry Kittles, Kendall Gill. And this is just, they got all kinds of knuckleheads on there. But that's what's up, dog. Right, let's get to this game, man. No, we're not playing the same guy. I always like to check and see if that's the case. We got the same jersey, though. He's got the white ones, of course. I have the red, just in case you didn't know. But, yeah, let's see how this goes. Starting off with two receiver set, one running back. Let's see what we can do here. Hey, good tackle. I don't know who that was, but good tackle, man. My goodness. Got to be careful. I don't know what it is, but it's like when you don't play, it's a little weird. Like when you don't play certain plays on certain runs. Like, guys can break away. I'm not really sure why that is, but guys can break away. I wonder why the last guy quit, though. I'm still curious about that. And this is actually, like, 1-something in the morning. I'm shocked that people are even playing draft champions. Like, wait for the blitz to get in. I'll take that. I'll take that all day. I was barely even paying attention. I got lucky when that blitz came in, though. Well, if the blitz don't come in, you're gonna get schooled. I'm gonna tell you that right now. I mean, you can be whoever you think you are, but shoot, you could be playing against Donald Duck or Roger Rabbit. I mean, if that blitz don't come in, somebody's gonna get open. They're gonna see that open person unless they just in a rush. Okay. This is what I wanted to be on. Oh wow, he went back too far. Ah, man. He went back. Well, I don't know why he went back that far. You know, I didn't want him to. He just got a speed boost for no reason. I don't know. That was kind of weird. I didn't necessarily think he was going to do that, but sometimes when guys go over the middle, guys do have the tendency to go over the middle on a third and long sometimes. That's why I like to have a guy there. I like to be the guy there. But this year, the defense takes weird angles. I'm not really sure why, but I got a good hit stick on right there. Sometimes the ball goes through people. But overall, I like this game, though. You know, I might have my, there are some things I don't like about it, but overall, I like the game. Because it's like you still got to hit the open guy, though. You know, you still got to have a certain skill. Like, you can't just be practically anybody on here, just getting on here and thinking you're going to get a win. Unless you just throw up a whole bunch of lob streaks. And still, I mean, the lob streaks get stopped, though. I know people complain about the lob streaks a lot, but they don't catch them all the time. You know, sometimes they catch them at the most inconveniencing time, though. It's a tricky line to walk. It's a tricky one because you got to ask yourself some questions sometimes when you're in these games. You know, or do you happen to be playing against an opponent that just happens to be really, really good? Or just as good as you? Why is your opponent in a position to get a Hail Mary? Because if you're that much better than your opponent, you know, you got the whole game. You got to make it so they don't have a position to get there. You know, you got to get them up out of there quick. If they ain't nowhere near you, like when I was younger, man, like when we played sports, it was just a cutthroat mentality for the most part, man. And you know, it was just, I remember the guy that used to teach me, I probably would have had that pick right there. The guy used to teach me how to ball, you know, I remember one time he said something about people not having any kill in them. Not necessarily like literally, of course, but like just when you play against somebody, when you know they ain't got no business being on the court with you, you know, you just give them that work, man. Just know, you can shake hands after the game, but you just give them that work. Like, you don't give them no life. You know, you don't give them no opportunity to to come back or give him no hope, nothing. You just destroy him, man. You know, he always would talk about that, and it always kind of resonated with me, man. And it's just this dude is really beating this dude off the. Wow, look at this. My goodness, I thought I baited that, but that angle. And some of these guys are not as fast, which makes sense though. That does make sense. They got that on fourth down too. My goodness, I should beat this guy though. This guy's beatable. You know, he's not gonna. I hope he doesn't think he's gonna get that the whole game. You know, but yeah, you know, we had a. See that angle my linebacker took? Why would he take that angle? I don't understand why he. Why was he way over there? That just didn't even make sense. You know, that was just a straight down. I probably would have missed him, but he should have went straight down the middle. He went way left. I'm not really sure. But, you know, yeah, we had a kind of a cutthroat mentality to a degree, man. I know I did. Me and my boys did, you know. So you got to ask yourself, you know, when you're in these games, why is if someone's not supposed to be, if you know someone, you're playing someone that's not on your level, get them up out of there, man. Get them up out. Beat them by 100, 130, 30, 15, whatever. Get them up out of there, you know, so they won't have no chance to throw a Hail Mary on you. Because if you get Hail Mary on, you've been playing around the whole game and you can't blame nobody but yourself. You know, and I understand things happen, you know, in this game, don't get me wrong. You know, sometimes guys get lucky and, you know, some of the weirdest stuff happens. I get that and, oh, snap, Roger Cromartie though. Look at this. I tried to spin on him. Good pick, man. Wow, he went out and just grabbed that one. I like that, man. That's what I'm talking about. Way to grab it. I understand crazy stuff happens in this game. Or crazy stuff, wild stuff happened to me. You guys have seen it. I've got some wild stuff off. You guys remember when Dontarion Poe in the Ultimate Team match got a 74-yard run. Just some wild. I mean, man, it's just wild. It's like the Wild Wild West out here, man. Wow, that was a hit, man. Whew. That was like a big boy right there. We're gonna run the ball a little bit. We're gonna try to mix it up a little bit, man. You know, that guy was open on the last play, so I hit him. You know what I mean? I think somebody's trying to play Word with the friends of me on the phone. But I think you guys get the message of what I'm saying, though. Yeah, I'll play that later. Oh, okay. I thought I did what's it called? A delay of game. I can say, oh man. You guys know I got my Dr. Pepper here with me. You already know. I'm a wrist cracker, but I ain't gonna be munching on them too much. Wow, good block share by somebody. That Ingram, man. I wonder what ranking is that Ingram? Because he's kind of causing a little bit of havoc here. He's causing some problems already. Yeah, he looks so huge on that first tackle. I said, man, goodness, he looked like he like Lawrence Taylor out there. I said, man, that Taylor. Don't run that way. Good catch by Bush. Oh, my. Wow, that was a good catch. I wasn't even sure if he was going to catch that. I didn't know how long he was going to hold on to that. I didn't know nothing. I just threw it because he was open. I was happy to catch it with the last second. Man, he wanted to take that for six. If you want to take him for six, I ain't going to stop you, that's for sure. And he's backing his guys up. I'm not really sure. I'm not sure who I'm playing here. He's trying to strip that ball, though. You got to be careful, because that could work. Man, you're going to get this work. Y'all remember that video? Y'all, you're going to get this work. And when he said it the first time, I knew it was over. When he said it the first time, I knew it was over, man. If he'd held on to that, I didn't expect him to hold on to that. You know, let's keep it real here. Michael Bush is a running back. That's not necessarily the best catcher. But, man, if he would have held on to that, man. That was a floater right there. That's one of those, I don't know what you, a Brett Favre kind of play. I don't know what to call it, man. But everybody don't get those plays, man, that's for sure. Good catch by Jackson, man. Good run. Way to get the first down. I'm not running it because I got to see my man. He's been – Michael Bush has been out here, and I kind of don't – okay, we got McFadden, though. All right. I didn't want him to get tired, you know. That's why I was like, you know. And sometimes, you know, you only get one running back sometimes. That's decent, you know. Sometimes you're lucky if you get two running backs. Now, I got two decent running backs with Jeff Chambers. I got kind of lucky. I should have checked earlier. I might have ran the ball a couple more times. And that block shed was expedient. That's for sure. Let's try it. I don't know if this is going to work, but you know what? I'm not going to try. We'll go to 2 minute warning. I don't mind doing the play action right here, but it's a little shaky for me sometimes. Well, I'm assuming that 2 minute warning is telling me to not do that. So I'm gonna pick a different play. I don't know what it is. I like that play there, you know, to the tight end on the outside, you know. You know what I mean? It's a play that a lot of people run, but it works a lot of times. So I understand why people run it though, you know. Like when I talk about Madden, I try to be as reasonable as I possibly. Oh wow. Dang, man, just hold on to that block a little bit longer. And I might have had him right there. I might have had a touchdown. Yeah, I try to talk as feasible as I possibly can. You know, a lot of guys, they talk about Madden and they just complain like crazy. You know, so that's why some people be like, man, stop complaining, you know, da-da-da-da, because they're getting tired of hearing the person complaining all the time. And some people, they just talk just to do talk because they have a platform. You know, they don't really necessarily put a lot of thought in what they're saying. So, you know, when you don't put a lot of thought into what you're saying, that's what it's going to sound like. Like you don't put a lot of thought into what you're saying. You know what I mean? So, you know, you just got to be kind of careful, man. Especially these people on those platforms. You know, you got Super Sniper Wolf and, you know, you got Raya and you got Mr. Golden Sports. And, you know, these guys, you know, including myself, you know, you guys got to be careful, you know. You know what I mean? You know, what you say, what you do. You know what I mean? It's crazy because I was going through the playlist not too long ago. Like I told you guys like yesterday, I set up my playlist and stuff. And guess what I found out? Cash Nasty actually wanted to play me in a game. I never knew in the NBA 2K game. I never knew, you know, way back when. But I got so many messages, man. Like, and then back then it was a little harder to track all your messages, but. I mean, I don't know if he'll hear this or somebody can tell him, but you gotta know I play anybody. You know, I don't have no problem with it. You know, hey, I tried to hit stick that fool. Hey, okay, this guy. I think I know what he likes to do now. This guy, you know, he's running the same two plays here. You know, man, see this dude is gonna be the same play really. Hey, way to break that up, you know. I would run a cover two, but these guys, when they get into the cover two, they drop back too far. The corners drop back too far. You know what I mean? I'm not really sure why, but yeah, man, Cash Nasty wanted to play me. I had no idea. I had to check and see if it was the right Cash Nasty, but yeah, it's him. You know, it's... It's him. I was like, wow, all right. You know, I had no idea. Okay, he has a different player now. Oh, wow. Well, I didn't sack him, but he got hit pretty hard. That's good. Geno Atkins, 96 overall. Right there. Geno Atkins making a play. You know, 96 overall, you should make at least one play in the game. You know, I don't know why, but Gerald McCoy and Geno Atkins, I don't know why, but when I have them on my team, I had both of them on my team at one point. They just don't perform that well. I don't know. Really. I don't know. I'm not sure it's because I'm playing against guys that have great offensive linemen. I'm not sure if it's that or this guy is really like going for it. Like he caught it though, but he ain't got enough. I mean, I'm not sure how long he thought he was gonna be able to do all that though. I mean, I'm not, you know. I ain't talking. Like, I could lose the game, but. Still, I mean, hopefully he don't just beat me with just that, you know what I mean? Gotta be something else, man. This dude backs everybody up for some reason. Not really sure why. Definitely called a timeout there. I'm not really sure if I feel like I'm playing like some little kid or something. I don't know. I mean, I don't care, but because some little kids will crush me, you know, so don't get that twisted. Or some guy doesn't know what he's doing or something. I don't know. I'm not really sure what it is. Oh, that's wow. Okay. The safety played that pretty good. I thought that was going to be a pick, but hey, I ain't gonna complain, you know. That's for sure. Safety played that real well. Oh, I really thought he was going to pick that off. Following the long play. Ryan's going to take it from the gun. And it's touchdown? All right, cool, cool. Oh, I caught a timeout. I thought it was a touchdown. Here we are late in the second quarter. They put up another touchdown, Phil. Well, they took a long time to put a touchdown. I thought it wasn't a touchdown. That's how I caught a timeout. Timeout wasted, but it's all good. I mean, it's the end of the half right here anyway, so. I don't know. I got a feeling this guy might quit. I'm not really sure. I don't know. Some people don't quit though. Some people that like me, I wouldn't quit because I would just use the time. I'm getting blown up. I don't know if I'm playing somebody that's clearly better than me. And use that time to try to, you know, work on your game. I was saying that's a bad 12. But people's pride getting away, you know. Like, I mean, I guess I don't know. And he decided to take off. He should just threw it. He should just threw the Hail Mary. He might have got it. We definitely gonna try to give him a heavy dose of the run this game. I mean, this half right here. I keep thinking that's Devin Hester, man, because he got the Atlanta Falcons jersey on. But we definitely gonna try to give him a heavy dose of this run, though. We're gonna see what that does. Whatever happened to Michael Bush? We got hurt or something? I don't even know. If somebody knows what happened to Michael Bush, let me know. I don't know if he got hurt or. Michael Bush is not running that bad, though. You know, he's hitting the holes pretty good. He's just a big boy. That's all that it is.
Second and six coming up.
Let's see what we got here. It looks good on the right, so we're going to go to the left. See where we go, okay. I'll take the first.
That's what you want to do. Get a first down while you're on top and keep that clock moving and just controlling the football game. Good job by the offense managing things so far here today.
The reason why I kind of did that a little bit, because like in the I formation, I like to have two or three sections, I prefer. But so I can have that hole was open. Wow, I tried to bust through it, but sometimes you try to bust through the hole. That's why sometimes I try to take my time through the holes, because you know, sometimes they don't hit the holes right. Running selection is limited in this playbook. But so I truthfully, I really got a passing team though, so I'm gonna run the ball because I mean, like I said, Michael Bush and Devin Fatter is not bad, but I'm running the ball mainly because I'm up and. I'm not really sure what kind of guy I'm playing here. I'm not really sure. You know what I mean? But, you know, Matty Ice, 9-for-7 from the field. All right. I throw a couple deep balls, let it spice it up a little bit after I get this run. I'm trying to give him some doses of the run. I definitely don't want that miracle comeback, you know. Oh, it looked good for a second, though. I mean, that McFadden, though, man. I remember I had McFadden. I think I had a 97 overall on, I believe it was the college football game. That McFadden, man. He's nice. I think it was a 97 overall on NCAA 14 for NCAA Ultimate Team. Falcons with a nickel look here on defense. Matt Ryan from the shotgun. Nelson's got the. Wow, look at that. Look at that. Dang, wide open right there. Wow, doesn't get much more open than that. I don't know what type of defense he was in right there, but that dude was kind of open. Now he there was a corner over there though, so that corner could have. You got to be careful with those passes because that corner could have dropped back and picked it off. I got a little lucky there, but still, I mean that's not what should happen, you know what I mean? But this game, you just never know. Peterson's got it on the return. All right, we are 21. Man. We got a nice lead here. So, oh, look at that! Wow, is that the game? Would that make my opponent quit? No. I think I got him on that one. I ain't gonna front. I think I got him on that one. Oh, boot review. Okay, man, he probably got it. That's overturned. Yeah, why? It looked like I hit it out of his hand. I was gonna go right for the end zone on that play, too. It's just always a clear shot. When I'm not sure why this guy's doing the same play. I don't know. And determine if it's a fumble or down by contact. But it has been working for him a little bit, though. But and that'll probably go as a drop. Hey, my man, he's dropping the ball. Everybody's in position. That ain't a good look. The quarterback to throw the football, and it leads to another incomplete pass. I know a lot of subscribers want to play me. And I'm playing a lot of subscribers. I'm going to try to get to all of them, but it's just tough. You know what I mean? Okay, he's playing. Okay, this is a different play. I haven't seen this play yet. Take that sack, though. It is tough because of my work schedule. That's what it really is. That's what it really comes down to. My work schedule is like, it's kind of, I don't know. Like, they didn't switch it up again. I don't know, man. Ooh, I smacked him right there. My goodness. That was with a gold linebacker, too. Ooh. My goodness. Damn, I might be catching a little bit of a cold here. I hope not, though. Okay, that's Gates. Okay, I thought that was Jackson doing that post route. We can try with Gates. Ah, I think I might have had it too with Gates. See, Gates is a little slow on that. Yeah, he was a little slow on that. Usually with a team like this, I would keep, especially in draft chambers, I would keep throwing and throwing it. But I'm trying to mix it up a lot. Like, you know, kind of play like I used to a little bit. Just do a combination of a nice run and pass combo. I'm trying to do it like that, but you know, I do like getting pass happy at the same time. You know, it's a struggle every time, man. It's like when I post these videos, man. It's like sometimes I'm like, okay, man, I told you this before. I want to post 3 videos a day. I want to post 1 video a day. I want to post 1 video at 9:00. I want to post a good break tackle. Wow, what a run! I don't usually do the inside zone like that, but that was a good run. I don't know if that was inside zone. Was that inside? Yeah, it was inside zone. Try a little outside zone. A little thunder, a little lightning. That note said that. Sean William Scott, The Rundown. Love that movie. I haven't seen that in a long time. Oh, look. Well, there you go. There you have it right there. I knew it was coming. I hope that's a loss on his part, not mine. We'll see in a moment here. My goodness. Now you never know, man. You can never be too careful. Okay, I did get the win. All right. All right, y'all, it's your boy.